Here at Creativa, when we make you a video, we want to make sure you don't have any trouble getting it out to your audience. Every social media platform is different, and sometimes the right settings can be tricky to find. In an effort to make the whole sharing process a little easier, we're going to show you the basic things you need to know to get your video up on socials. We'll first cover some general tips before demonstrating here on the computer how to upload to Vimeo, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, and yes, even TikTok. Using the timestamps in the description or the progress bar, you can skip forward to the section you need. But first, some general tips. A good general rule of thumb is to post the video natively on each social platform you want the video to appear. Use their own tools rather than copying and pasting a YouTube link. The algorithms tend to treat that better. Everything we're going to show you today is from a desktop computer. Good as the mobile apps are, it's far easier to do all that we're about to suggest from your PC or Mac. Each social platform has its own specifications, but wherever possible, with the exception of YouTube, use the square version of your video if you have one. They take up more screen real estate and increase the likelihood of a video catching someone's eye as they're scrolling down the page. Did you know the vast majority of social media users watch videos without sound? To ensure everyone gets the most from your content, including those who are hearing impaired, we strongly recommend you attach the SRT captions file that comes as part of your video delivery package. After all, it's included at no extra cost. Use a custom thumbnail. Don't rely on the automated tools. Have something enticing for the viewer to click on, stick to the subject matter, and keep text to big, bold keywords only. Like thumbnails, you'll want to grab people's attention with titles and a description that encourages them to watch the video. Tease what the audience might be about to see, pose a question, and be sure to include relevant links and hashtags. With all that said and done, let's show you how to get your video uploaded. Let's start with YouTube, which is thankfully nice and easy. Hit the little camera icon in the top right corner. From the pop-up, you'll be able to press the blue Select Files button and choose the right video file for YouTube. Remember, your normal rectangular video is best here. Enter the video's title and description and scroll down a little to find the thumbnail options. Click on the empty rectangle to the left with Upload Thumbnail written in it and select the image file from your computer. For YouTube, it needs to be below 2 megabytes in size. If it's too big, try using TinyJPEG or another online compression tool. Before you move on to, select a playlist to include the video in, if you have some already set up. If you haven't, consider making some to group like with like content. Unless you're making a video specifically for kids or something that's very likely to appeal to kids, select No here. Clicking Yes will lock off features you probably don't want to lose. Before you move on to, be sure to scroll right down to the bottom and hit More Options. As promised, more settings will present themselves, including tags or relevant keywords and subtitles. Hit the blue Upload Subtitles text and leave With Timing checked before hitting Continue. Your file explorer will load and you can select the provided SRT file from your computer. All that's left now is to skip over to the Visibility tab up the top and choose if you want to set the video live right away or schedule it for a later date. If you want to keep it private but share it amongst your colleagues in the meantime, you can save it to Unlisted so that anyone with the link can view it as well. Facebook changes their systems like no one's business, but their latest revamp to Creator Studio is actually a godsend. If you've not used it before, I'm excited to introduce you to it. Head to business.facebook.com/creatorstudio and log into the Facebook account associated with the profile or page you want to post the video. Once there, you can hit Create Post in the top left corner and select Upload Video from midway down the list. Then choose the right video file. If you've got a square one, now is its time to shine. Add a title, a description in the box below, and some tags. On the right, hit Thumbnail, and from the second option, press Add Image to upload your custom thumbnail. None of the auto-generated images are likely to be any better, trust me. Next is captions. but it's important to note Facebook's a bit fussy with the file name for the SRT captions file. We need to add a language and a country code to the end of the file name. This is written in British English, so I'll write EN_GB at the end here. To upload the newly named file, you can find the caption settings below the thumbnail option from the list on the right. Look for the upload button and select the file. Wrapping things up, click on the second tab at the top labeled Publishing Options and choose when you'd like the post published. Like YouTube, you can schedule it for a later date. On the right, you'll see a list of nice-to-have checkboxes. That means the video reacts well to Facebook's algorithm. Per their shift to quality content, they like videos to be over 3 minutes long, in HD, have a description, some tags, and be in a playlist. To score that last point, you can scroll down the page and select a playlist or create one if you haven't already. One of the amazing things about Facebook's Creator Studio is its ability to upload and schedule videos to Instagram from your computer. If your Instagram page is linked to a Facebook account and you've got admin or editor access to that Facebook page, you can post it to Instagram too, no problem. Log into Creator Studio and select the Instagram icon from the two social media icons in the top middle of the screen. Then hit Create Post and choose between Instagram Feed or IGTV. IGTV is ideal for most purposes, but if your video is under 15 seconds, you'll need to make it a feed post. For an Instagram feed post, it's pretty basic, just a caption and the content. Scheduling options are accessible via the blue drop-down arrow in the bottom right corner, next to the publish button. IGTV posts are a little more complex, but in a good way. Selecting From File Upload in the tall empty rectangle to the left allows you to select the video file from your computer. Add a title and a caption to the right, and select Share Preview to Feed should you want a square preview of the video on your profile alongside all your other posts. On the right, you can hit Cover Image and upload a custom thumbnail, which you'll need to have a vertical or 9:16 aspect ratio, the sort of size an Instagram story or a Snapchat would be. Bear in mind, if you're sharing a preview to your feed, only the middle square will be visible, whereas under the IGTV tab, the full thumbnail will be seen. But with all that sorted, you're free to hit publish or schedule the post by clicking the downwards arrow to the right of the publish button. Video is also no problem for LinkedIn, but unfortunately, it's not the easiest thing to schedule. You can use a service like Hootsuite to schedule LinkedIn posts, but you're unable to change the title, add a custom thumbnail, or add captions to your video. It's not the end of the world, but it's also not ideal, so I'd recommend using LinkedIn's own tools if you can put the post up live straight away. Head to your LinkedIn page and hit Start a Post up the top. Enter a description and hashtags in the field that pops up and hit the video icon from the list of attachment options. Select the video from your computer, add a title above, and your thumbnail and caption file from the options below. Hit Done and you'll be taken back to your post to double check everything. If you want to make any changes to your video, you can by clicking the little pencil icon in the top right corner. Otherwise, you can hit post when you're ready. Twitter video uploads are a relatively simple process too, although with some limitations. Unless you're one of the lucky few to have received an invite from Twitter to use their media studio, you can't use custom thumbnails or add subtitles. Otherwise, throwing a video up and scheduling it is a piece of cake. Up the top, where it says what's happening, add your description and hashtags. Then click on the picture icon below. Select the video file from your computer, noting that if it's longer than 2 minutes and 20 seconds, you'll have to trim it down slightly. With the video uploaded, you can hit the tweet button to post it straight away, or press the little calendar icon to the left to schedule a time for the video to post. Uploading videos to Vimeo isn't all too different from uploading a video to YouTube. Once you're logged in, hover over the new video button in the top right corner and select Upload. Drag and drop your video onto the next page or hit Choose Files and select the video file to get your video uploading. Add a title, a description, choose your privacy, and add some tags. For all the additional steps, we need to hit the cog icon. On this screen, you'll get loads more options for your video. In this general section, we can add a custom thumbnail by clicking on the Edit Thumbnail drop-down menu and selecting Upload, choosing a file, and hitting Open. Scrolling down, you'll find the Collections section with a list of showcases, the Vimeo equivalent of playlists on YouTube and Facebook. Check the box for each showcase you'd like to add it to, or hit the little plus icon to add another. Finally, we can add captions by navigating to the Distribution tab on the left and selecting Subtitles from the list. In the Subtitles section, click the little plus icon. Select the language and subtitles from the drop-down options. Select Choose File and open the correct SRT file from your computer to upload it. Don't forget to hit Save to apply your changes, and when you're ready to share it publicly, head back to General Settings and change its privacy. Did you know you can upload a video to TikTok from your computer too? It doesn't have all the bells and whistles the app does, so if you want to get funky with all the music and filter options TikTok offers, you'd better stick to using the phone. Whilst it's super easy to do, it still doesn't support captions, but you can add them in manually using the phone app's creative text tools. Otherwise, uploading your video to TikTok from your computer is super easy. Just head to TikTok.com, log into your account, and click this cloud icon in the top right corner. Click on this empty space to the left to select a file, add a description and some hashtags in the box up the top, and scroll through your video's frames to pick a preview. Again, there's no option to add a custom thumbnail or captions here. Adjust the visibility and engagement options as you choose, hit post, and you're done. Hopefully that's covered all of the basics. If there's anything else we can do to help, be sure to drop a comment below or get in touch. And if you'd like to learn more about Creativa, all that we do, and see some examples of our work, check out our website at creativa.com.au. Catch you next time.